Now we come to the section formula for vectors. Till now what we had done was for the coordinate geometry. The concept remains the same. See what happens. Say this is my point. Let us say this is P and this is Q and this is my position vector and I prefer to call it A. This is a position vector. I could have called it R1. Okay, I would have preferred R1. And here it is. Here it is B. Okay, B. I want the actually you want the same thing. See, I want this R. Okay, what is the position vector? Because now what happens in vectors? The position vectors, they start indicating the points. Okay, earlier the coordinates were indicating the points in the coordinate geometry that we just did. Here what happens? Here our position vectors start indicating the point, and I am stuck with the same problem. What is that position vector with at point R that will divide the line segment connecting them in the ratio m is to n? Okay, now how do we go about it? How do we go about it? What will we do? See, I can very well find this vector, no? RP vector. What is RP? What is RP vector? Or PR vector, PR. See, A plus PR gives you R. According to the triangle law of addition, or you could have applied that we had just done. If these are two points, and so this is R1, this is R2, this is R1, this is R2, then this becomes what? R2 minus R1, and this becomes this. So wherever your head is, that vector comes first. So PR is given by R minus A. R minus A. What is my RQ?
B minus R.
Yeah. It is definitely B minus R. Okay. Now you'll find one thing. What is the length of this? What is the ratio of the length of these? I mean to ask, what is PR? PR is equal to MK and RQ is equal to NK. Is it not? So now what happens? What do I see? After all, they are collinear vectors, right? They are collinear vectors and they are parallel vectors, correct? So what do I do? What do I do with them? Or you think it that this way? How can I make them unit vector? The two, three ways of doing the same thing. See, its length is what? MK. So if I divide it by mk, it becomes a unit vector in this direction. So I'm trying to find out this p r cap is what? Vector p r upon p r. Now vector p r is r minus a divided by p r is mk. Okay, r q unit vector is r q vector divided by r q. Now r q is what? B minus a, b minus r, sorry, divided by n k. Now do you think that p r and r q are the same? Are they equal? Yes. Why? Because they are pointing in the same direction. What is the definition for equality of vectors? When are two vectors said to be equal? When they point in the same direction and they have the same magnitude. What is their magnitudes? They have become unit vectors. So their magnitude is? What is their direction? You see, they point in the same direction. Why? Because they are along the same line. They are collinear vectors and parallel. Had they been anti-parallel, then they would have become negative of each other. So they are actually equal. So P r cap is equal to r q cap. Now that gives you r minus a upon m k is equal to b minus r upon n k. So it gives you n into r minus a is equal to m into b minus r. M. So it becomes mr plus nr is equal to mb plus na. So I get now it looks like the same. It looks absolutely the same. What has happened? M has got multiplied with B, N has got multiplied with A, added, divided by M plus N. Now the beauty of this equation is this. It contains all the three informations of x, y, z within itself. You understand why? How? Because if it is in 3D, this point is x1, y1, z1, say. This is x, y, z, say. This is x2, y2, z2, say. Okay? So you just plug in the values. What will be A? A will be x1 I cap plus y1 plus z1, x2 I cap, z2 k cap, x I cap, y j cap, z k cap. What happens? What happens? You just plug it in. Plug those values there. So you get x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap is equal to m times x2 I cap plus y2 j cap plus z2 k cap plus, I'm writing it below, n times x1 I cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap upon m plus n. So this becomes what? This becomes mx2 plus nx1 i1, mx2 plus nx1 I cap, my2 plus ny1 j cap, plus mz2 plus nz1 k cap divided by m plus n. Do you get that? I have taken together, I have collected the I cap coefficient, j cap coefficient and k cap coefficient. That's all I have done. Here you have x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Now, do you see something? It says this is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n I cap my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n j cap mz2 plus nz1 upon m plus n k cap, and this is equal to this. Start equating the, when are two vectors said to be equal? When their corresponding I j k coefficients are the same. If you equate it, you get three equations. X is equal to mx2 plus nx1 upon m plus n, y is equal to my2 plus ny1 upon m plus n, z is equal to mz2 plus mz1 upon m plus n. You understand what is happening? The vector in itself is storing the information for all the three scalar equations. You understand? That is the power of vectors. So I do not, and you see how simply it became this. Even the derivation was pretty simple. What did I apply? I just applied two concepts. One was the concept of the equality of vectors, and the other was the property of addition of vectors. That's all. I did nothing else. Okay. Externally, it can again be proved that the negative comes in. That I'll do next.